Hey folks, now you're seeing I'm open two tabs and also with two apps activated on my computer. And in this video, I want to share a few things about these two apps, which both for recording your screens. And I really like them, and there are some difference between these two apps. One named Screen Studio, the other named FocuSee, right? So here are a few things that I want to say about these two apps. First is about the price. So FocuSee and Screen Studio are both for recording screens, and they're really good. I started to use Screen Studio a while ago, and the quality is the best. I don't have anything to complain. And currently it works really good. The only thing that I find could be improved is the speed, because now when exporting video, it actually takes a lot of time for doing that. And the price, we can see standard price, standard license is $89, which is not that expensive, but also it's not very cheap. And also it's only available for one macOS device, and also pretty much, and including a year of updates. And the other two options, $189, and that's for three devices, will be good for a team collaboration. And that's the basic thing about the price. And on FocuSee, do they have the price on their homepage? Not sure. Oh, here. Yeah, the price is two computer, $95.99, and for one computer is $69.99. And actually, it's cheaper than Screen Studio. But I have to say, this free version that FocuSee provide for recording screen, it's also quite good. It support 720p, which is already good enough for recording. And now, if I started to record, let's just record a short video on both and see how's the difference. So now I'm start to record on Screen Studio. So you see it's already activated, and we can see these parts to select different window or display or area or even device. And I can select my input, microphone or camera, or even the system audio. So now I'm just simply record a quick part. Maybe I just select, you can see I can highlight. Maybe I just record their website just for fair, right? So I start to record this screen. I can browse to the top and I can highlight this part, scrolling down, and check other things. And even if I want, I can play some videos. And that's all. I think that's for now. This screen, I can browse to the top and I can highlight this part, scrolling down, and check other things. So you can see that I'm recording this screen and it's in the center. And also I can set with the padding so that I can see some part of the background. And even I can reset it, and same the original size. Let's see, if I want to export to YouTube, I can use this wide 69 resolution, or even vertical if I want to export into short YouTube shorts or TikTok. And I can change the background. I can set the round corner and many things I can insert. So I can select, I can change the style of the format. And the other thing is the cursor. One thing that they did really well, this app is doing really well, is the cursor animation. What it means. So for example, if you see my cursor is moving on the screen, that's actually quite smooth. You might notice that. For example, now this screen, I can browse to the top and I can highlight this part. If you notice my cursor,
and check other things. And even if I want, I can play some.
You might notice that it's moving really smooth, and I like that, because it feels that something like a studio quality video. And also I can change the camera position or other things. So that's straightforward. I can change the roundness and the size of the corner of the camera. And yeah, pretty much that's quite simple. And you might notice that I have this zoom feature, which is the core feature of this of this app, and it's also available on the other app. So yeah, and then I can add captions. So for the caption, I can generate transcripts directly from the app. But normally I just use another tool for doing that. So not the topic for today. Right, so I really like it, and I really like the animation and the motion blur or other things, and make it really with the style. And then I can export. Then I can export in MP4, a video, or GIF. So these are really helpful if I want to just capture something quickly moving on the screen and export it. And then I can just click export to file to save it. And now I'm just stop doing that. So this is Screen Studio. And now let's see FocuSee how it goes. I'll just start to do the same thing on FocuSee, and this time I'm doing things with the FocuSee's website. So you might notice that, okay, it can support, I can select different cameras, different input audio channel, and I can also record the system audio, which is good. Now I'm just to record this website, and now since it's already selected, I can just hit the record button, and now it's recording. Right, so now I'm on this page. I can highlight it. By the way, the web page Screen Studio seems much better than FocuSee's web page, and that could be a difference, because when you have some interest about the product, when you browse the landing page, this one definitely want encourage you to check more details and maybe you won't buy it, right? And now you can check here, right? And I'm just scrolling and also checking some questions. I just want to test the recording function. Now should be enough. Let's stop this. So you might notice something different. You might notice something that same, right? First, like the quality of the video, I don't know if that different, but now I can see it seems quite the same, and I can also use the different background. By the way, they use the similar background. I just wonder why to make it similar. Why don't you just make something different? Because it seems like a duplicated from the other app, right? I guess it's probably just royalty free, and if you can maybe do something different, developers will for that. But now I'm just select a different background, and I can set padding, insert roundness, that's all good. And yeah, and also I can set it to different resolution, that's good. And it seems that I can only select the background or the video enhancement. I can select the cursor, and I can set the camera. So you notice there's no captions or other thing, but let's see how this performance is going. So yeah, this part is pretty much the same. And when the recording play, you might notice the cursor movement is not as good as Screen Studio. It seems just records what the cursor looks on when I'm actually using this app. But if I see on this part, I zoom it down. On this part, the cursor seems bigger and moving quite smoother and also quite clear to see. So that's the difference. I think that's probably a very key difference. For me, I would like to use Screen Studio just because the cursor looks better, because that's the key. Right, and then I can see, right here I can set the cursor. I can set the size of the cursor. Let's see if moving it to a bigger size. You might notice, I don't know if you can notice, because I can see it, like the smoothness is different on Studio, Screen Studio, and on FocuSee it's loose. Seems not with enough rate. I don't know, but it feels not like match my need. But here I can select different types of the cursor, and it's quite interesting because this one seems old fashioned, and some other things just seems they need a designer for doing something people really want to use. But yeah, this one seems quite cool, and I can select mouse click effect. Okay, that's good. Yeah, that's good. Because for some video recording, this might be really helpful. And for the camera, that's good. I can select different filter, which could be quite handy, because sometimes I don't want to use the filter on the whole video because we might change the performance on the major screen, but I don't like the performance on myself on my camera, and in that case I can use it. And also I can set, oh, this one could be quite handy, it's like a flip horizontal so that I can stand aside beside the screen recording. That could be handy. Right, I'll set it back, and seems I can set some camera frame so that I can use. And I still think they need a designer for make it really like people want to use those frames. Now at least for myself, I don't want to use those frames. Okay, so that's pretty much the major thing on this app, and I think that's it. And I can select different resolution and other things. And since these two apps are based on small startups, so at least I know that Screen Studio is an independent developer, Adam. So he's working on this one. And by the way, amazing work, amazing work. I think that's really, really the best, one of the best apps that I've used in this year. So really, really encouraged me to create more content. And for FocuSee, I think there are a few experience performance, but maybe make something different, or like if there are anything you can differentiate from this app so that it can make this market even bigger. And yeah, that's pretty much my comment about this recording app, and hope you like it. Right, I'll see you in the next one.